Hi, my name is Alibaba. In today's video, I will provide you intro of cloud computing. So let's start. What is cloud computing? So you almost probably use some type of cloud computing every day if you use a computer or mobile device at home or at work. Whether it's a cloud application like Google Gmail or Salesforce or streaming video like Netflix or cloud file storage like Dropbox. Cloud computing refers to the delivery of various services through the internet. These tools and applications comprise software, servers, databases, networking, and data storage, among other things. With cloud-based storage, files can be saved to a distinct database as opposed to being kept on a proprietary hard drive or local storage device. As long as an electronic gadget has internet connectivity, it has access to data and software applications to operate it. The phrase cloud computing also refers to the technology that enables cloud computing to work. This comprises some type of virtualized IT infrastructure such as servers, operating systems, networking, and other infrastructure that has been abstracted using specialized software to allow polling and dividing without regard to actual hardware boundaries. One hardware server, for instance, may be split up into several virtual servers. Cloud services companies can utilize the full potential of their data center resources thanks to virtualization. It should come as no surprise that many businesses have chosen the cloud delivery model for their on-premises infrastructure in order to get the most out of it, save money over traditional IT infrastructure, and provide the same level of self-service and agility to their customers. Cloud computing is becoming increasingly popular among individuals and organizations for a variety of reasons, including cost savings, enhanced productivity, speed, efficiency, performance, and security. Cloud computing gets its name from the fact that the information being accessed is located remotely in the cloud or a virtual space. Users may store files and apps on faraway servers and then access the data through the internet. This enables the user to access it remotely as they are not needed to be in a certain location to do so. With the help of cloud computing, you may process data without having to carry along the same device you work at or carry out heavy equipment. Additionally, it transfers all of that work to enormous computer clusters located far away in the cyberspace. Your data, work, and apps are accessible from any device that can connect to the internet wherever in the globe as the internet turns into the cloud. Companies from all industries may benefit from using cloud-based software, which can be accessed by browser or native apps on any device. Users may seamlessly transfer their data and settings from one device to another as a consequence. Cloud computing is much more than merely accessing data across different devices. Users may check their email on any computer and save files using services like Dropbox and Google Drive. Cloud computing services also allow customers to backup their music, data, and images, guaranteeing that those assets are promptly available in the case of a hard drive crash. It also has enormous possibilities for cost savings for large enterprises. Companies had to invest in pricey information management infrastructure and technology, purchases, construction, and maintenance before the cloud became a practical substitute. Fast internet connections can replace expensive server farms and IT staff in business, allowing workers to do jobs online by interacting with the cloud. The cloud architecture enables people to save up storage space on their PCs or laptops. Software businesses may now sell their wares online rather than through more conventional, tangible ways like disk or flash drives, which allows customers to upgrade software more quickly. Customers of Microsoft 365, for instance, can use an online subscription to access programs included in it, like Microsoft Word. This makes it simple for consumers to obtain updates and patches for their apps. So there are three major types of cloud computing services, which are software as a service, platform as a service, and infrastructure as a service. It's not unusual for an organization to employ all three. SaaS stands for Software as a Service. Application software that is hosted in the cloud and that users access via web browser, a specialized desktop client, or an API that connects with a desktop or mobile operating system is known as SaaS, sometimes known as cloud-based software or cloud apps. Users of SaaS often pay a monthly or yearly membership fee, while some may provide pay-as-you-go pricing depending on actual usage. There are hundreds of thousands of SaaS solutions available, ranging from the most specialized industry and departmental apps to a sophisticated enterprise databases and artificial intelligence software. SaaS is the main distribution strategy for the majority of commercial software today. PaaS stands for Platform as a Service. PaaS offers an on-demand platform for managing, running, and creating applications without the expense, complexity, and rigidity of maintaining that platform on-premises. This platform includes hardware, the full software stack, infrastructure, and even development tools. When using PaaS, the cloud provider hosts everything in their data center, including servers, networks, storage, operating system software, middleware, and databases. IaaS stands for Infrastructure as a Service. Infrastructure as a Service offers pay-as-you-go online access to the most basic computer resources, including networking, storage, and virtual servers. With the help of Infrastructure as a Service, end users may scale up and down resources as needed, eliminating the need for large upfront capital investments, pointless on-premises or own infrastructure, and overpurchasing resources to account for occasional spikes in consumption. Infrastructure as a Service gives consumers the most basic degree of control over the computing resources in the cloud, in contrast to Software as a Service and Platform as a Service. When cloud computing first started to gain popularity in the 2010, Infrastructure as a Service was the most often used paradigm. Although it continues to be the cloud model for many different types of workloads, but Software as a Service and Platform as a Service usage is expanding far more quickly. The key players in the cloud computing service providers are AWS, which stands for Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, Google Cloud, IBM Cloud, Alibaba Cloud. There are four types of cloud computing, which are namely public cloud, private cloud, hybrid cloud, and hybrid multi-cloud. In a public cloud, a cloud service providers make computing resources such as software as a service apps, individual virtual machines, bare metal computing hardware, whole enterprise-grade infrastructures, and development platforms accessible to users through a public network. These services may be freely available or access may be charged for using them in accordance with subscription-based or pay-per-usage pricing structures. The public cloud provider typically offers high bandwidth network connectivity to guarantee high performance and quick access to applications and data. It also typically owns, manages, and assumes full responsibility for the data center's hardware and infrastructure on which its customers' workloads run. The infrastructure of the cloud provider's data center is shared by all the customers of the public cloud, which is a multi-tenant environment. These customers can number in the millions on the top public clouds. Because public cloud service providers are elastic and easily scalable, they are being used by many businesses to move sections of their computer infrastructure to the cloud. This flexibility allows them to adapt to changing workload needs. Some are attracted by the promise of increased productivity and fewer resources consumed because consumers only pay for what they really use. Others aim to save costs for on-site infrastructure and hardware. A private cloud is a cloud environment where a single client has exclusive access to all cloud infrastructure and computing resources. Private clouds combine the access control, security, and resource customization of on-premises infrastructure with many of the advantages of cloud computing, such as elasticity, scalability, and simplicity of service delivery. Usually, a private cloud is hosted at the client's data center on-site. However, a private cloud can also be constructed on rented infrastructure located in an off-site data center or hosted on the infrastructure of a different cloud provider. Because private cloud is the only way to satisfy regulatory compliance requirements, many businesses prefer it over public cloud. Others prefer private clouds because their workloads involve sensitive information such as financial data, medical records, intellectual property, and secret papers. In a nutshell, private clouds use a company's own infrastructure, whereas public clouds use common infrastructure. Since public clouds are by definition hosted by a public cloud provider, they reduce the burden of managing the infrastructure. When compared to public clouds, private clouds are generally more expensive. The term hybrid cloud refers to a combination of public and private cloud infrastructure. An organization's private cloud services and public clouds are specifically and ideally connected to provide a unified, flexible infrastructure for operating its applications and workloads. The objective of a hybrid cloud is to provide a combination of public and private cloud resources with some degree of orchestration between them. This will allow an organization to freely shift workloads between the two clouds as needed and to select the best cloud for any application or task. This makes it possible for the company to accomplish its technological and business goals more successfully and affordably than it could have done with just public or private cloud. The usage of two or more clouds from two or more separate providers is known as multi-cloud. Using email, software as a service from one vendor, and picture editing software as a service from another may create a multi-cloud setup quickly and easily. However, when businesses discuss employing multiple clouds, they often mean using software as a service, platform as a service, and infrastructure as a service from two or more of the top public cloud providers. The usage of two or more public clouds alongside a private cloud is known as hybrid multi-cloud. Multi-cloud management technologies enables visibility across different provider clouds via a centralized dashboard, allowing development teams to view their projects and deployments, operations team to monitor cluster and nodes, and cybersecurity teams to check for threats. So, some of the most common advantages of using cloud computing are cost savings, security, flexibility, increased collaboration, quality control, disaster recovery, loss prevention, automatic software updates, sustainability. So that's it from today's video. Thanks for watching. If you found it helpful, please share with others and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.